Hey everyone, this is Dr. Kazi, and in this video, we are going to learn about the various routes of drug administration, which mainly consist of the enteral, parenteral, and the topical. Then finally, what is the difference between the oral, sublingual, and the buccal routes of drug administration? Now, when you are taking the drug into your body, the pathway through which you will take the medication or the drug is determined by these two factors, the properties and the therapeutic use. The drug administration route or the pathway will be determined by the properties of the drug and its therapeutic use. Sometimes we need medications for rapid onset of the reaction, or we need rapid relief of the pain. So we use the rapid onset actions, and other times we use medication for long-term treatment. Now, these properties will affect the pathway. For example, water solubility, lipid solubility, and the ionized form, because the ionized form cannot cross through the lipid membrane. If the medication is in the liquid form, we can inject it through the intravenous injection or take it orally. If the medication is in the gaseous form, we need to inhale it through nasal inhalations or the oral inhalations. So these factors will determine by the properties and the therapeutic use. Now, there are three major routes through which you can take the medication into your body. These are the enteral, parenteral, and the topical routes. Have a look at this diagram. The word enteral means intestine. So this route is any path which leads to your gastrointestinal tract or your alimentary tract. The enteral route mainly consists of the oral, sublingual, and the buccal. Also, the rectal route is included in the enteral route. Now, the parenteral route is concerned with the pathway which is directly connected with your blood system or the systemic circulation. The parenteral route consists of sublingual injections, intramuscular injection, and the intravascular injections. There are some other pathways which are topical. So for example, you apply some kind of ointment or cream on your skin in order to get relief yourself of the certain diseases. You use nasal inhalators or the oral inhalations for the treatment of various diseases. Now, let's talk a little bit detail about the enteral route of drug administration. Have a look at this diagram. The enteral route consists of the oral, sublingual, and the buccal region. You can take the drug orally, put it in your mouth, or you can put the drug under your lip, under your tongue, so it is sublingual, and you can put it in a space between your cheeks and the gum, so it is the buccal route. Now, the enteral route has certain advantages over the parenteral route and the topical route. It is the safest, common, and economical. The enteral medications are very cheap as comparison to the topical routes and the parenteral routes. Have a look at the advantages and the disadvantages. The biggest advantage of the enteral route is we can take the medications ourselves. The patient can take the medication himself, so it is self-administered, and the toxicities can be overcome with the use of antidotes. If a patient takes a lot of medication, we can cure the toxicities or overdose of the medication with the use of antidotes. Now, there are certain disadvantages of the enteral routes. Because the pathway of absorption is very complex, the drug can be absorbed in your oral cavity or in your stomach or in your intestines. Also, the low pH of the gastrointestinal tract deactivates or destroyed certain enteral medication. So the medication which we use through the oral route can be protected from the degradation by the acidity of the stomach and the intestine by two methods. We can apply some kind of chemical envelope on the drug in order to protect it from the low pH or the acidic environment of the gastrointestinal tract. So we have two ways, the enteric coated medications and the extended release medication. Have a look at this diagram. We have chemical envelope which is protecting the core, which is present at its center. The core contains the real medicine. Now, when you take this enteric coated medication through your mouth or oral cavity, this medication is not absorbed in your stomach. The acidity of the stomach has no effect on this medication. It cannot destroy this medication because of this coating, which is protecting the inner core. Eventually, when this medication reaches the small intestines, this whole chemical coat is dissolved and the drug is released. The examples are omeprazole and aspirin. Omeprazole and aspirin are the examples of enteric coated medication. Now, have a look at the extended release medicines. Again, it also consists of the special coating which is protecting the drug, which is present at its center. Now, one very important thing about the special coating is that it controls the release of absorption. The absorption of this medication is very slow. That's why the duration or the effect of this medication is prolonged. The enteric coated is shown by the symbol XR or ER. Now, the major advantage of the enteric extended release medication is that it is good for those medicine which have very short half-life. For example, oral morphine, which you take through the oral medication, have a half-life of 2 to 4 hours. Now, you have to take this medication 6 times daily if it is not protected by this special coating. If you have a special coating on this oral morphine, you only have to take 2 doses of this medication, which is the extended release oral morphine. Now, let's talk about the sublingual or the buccal medication. Sublingual means under your tongue. Have a look at this diagram. And the buccal means the space between your cheeks and the gum. Now, the sublingual, your lower sublingual region have a lot of blood supply, which is directly connected with your heart. So, when you take medication through the sublingual route, it diffuses into the capillary network present under your tongue and it enters the systemic circulation directly. Because of this, the sublingual and the buccal have the immediate effect compared with the intravenous injections. The advantages are, it doesn't have to pass through the harsh environment of your gastrointestinal tract, and also the first pass metabolism does not occur in case of sublingual and the buccal medication. The first pass metabolism occurs in your liver and in your intestines. This is all about the major routes of drug administration. In the next video, we are going to discuss about the parenteral and the topical route. Please do like, share and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.